When working with all TI devices, it is necessary to review the TI datasheet, which can be found on TI.com. Measuring op-amp parameters such as power supply rejection ratio can be a challenging task. In today's video, we'll cover how to troubleshoot power supply rejection ratio as defined by the TI datasheet. Before continuing, let's review some of the online resources which TI has for power supply rejection ratio. Those are TI Precision Labs, op-amps, power supply rejection ratio, TI's Analog Engineer's Pocket Reference Guide, and a video on how to complete an ABA swap. In addition, TI provides free simulation software known as Tina TI, which can be downloaded at the web address provided. There are various op-amp parameters which need to be verified. In order to make this process efficient, we can utilize op-amp test loops. For this example, we'll cover the false summing junction. The false summing junction schematic is provided in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. The benefit of the false summing junction is its simplicity and its small form factor. This is mainly due to the fact that the majority of DC parameters can be determined with just four resistors. Offset voltage is defined as the input differential voltage required to force the output to mid-supply. This is best measured in the false summing junction at the false summing junction node provided in the upper right-hand corner of the screen at V sub J of S. An offset voltage equation is provided at the bottom of the screen. This equation is derived from Kirchhoff's voltage law using the schematic provided. In this example, we see that the offset is approximately equal to 10 microvolts. Before we begin measuring power supply rejection ratio of a linear amplifier, let's recall the definition of power supply rejection ratio. Power supply rejection ratio is defined as the change in offset voltage divided by the change in supply. It's important to consider transition regions for linear rail-to-rail amplifiers. The figure shown on this slide provides a visualization of why the transition region should be considered. As you can see, there are various regions which may affect the linear slope of the PSRR based on where the offset voltage is being measured. Please refer to your TI datasheet, which can be found on TI.com, for test conditions on how to measure PSRR for the TI component. For the OPA 192 example, power supply rejection ratio conditions are shown as follows. Now let's verify how to measure PSRR of an OPA 192. In this example, we'll use a universal prototyping board, otherwise known as a breadboard. In addition, we'll use a power supply and a digital multimeter to read the output voltage of the false summing junction circuit. In this first condition, we'll measure the offset at approximately plus or minus 15 volts. In the plus or minus 15 volt condition, we see the offset voltage is approximately equal to 294 microvolts to 300 microvolts. Let's enter that into our spreadsheet. We see that the offset of the amplifier is approximately 2.9 microvolts. Now let's measure the offset voltage at a power supply condition of plus or minus 6 volts. Remember to turn off the power supply voltage before changing conditions. In this condition, we see the output of the false summing junction circuit is approximately equal to 198 microvolts to 200 microvolts. In our spreadsheet, that equates to 2.9 microvolts per volt. In this example, we see the PSRR of this device is approximately 0.002 microvolts per volt. I've shown you how to measure PSRR of a linear amplifier. It's important to remember that all information necessary to test datasheet parameters can be found in the product datasheet. For datasheet information, please refer to TI.com. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting video on how to measure PSRR of a linear amplifier.